So now under connections, we'll have some contact. These contacts are automatically generated. Now some are showing question mark because we have changed some flexible bodies to rigid bodies. That's the reason there is a question mark. Now let's just delete this because we will be going to give manual contact regions. So manual contact regions. So now let me just tell you what is this contact regions. So what is this contacts? What is this all this about contacts? So during the simulation, our components should not penetrate into each other. So to avoid that penetration, we'll give some contact at the surface level, mainly a contact and the target. So there will contact region and the target region. So when this contact region and target regions is associated to some face of a component, those face will not never get penetrated into each other. So the force or the load transfer will happen at their face level, at the surface level. So for an example, if the contact is not given between punch and the blank, what will happen is as the punch moves downwards, the punch will start penetrating into the blank without load transfer and will start simply passing through it. But when you give a contact, the punch starts to move downwards. When the contact region and the target regions meets, so the punch still moves downward, still keeps on going, moving downwards, but the load transfer will happen from punch to blank. Then only afterwards our blank starts moving to the die. Similarly, for blank and die, there has to be contact because we don't want our blank to penetrate into die. So we'll be giving this contact. So let me just first give the contact between. So the contact and the target. Okay, now insert another manual contact region, duplicate it. Now this time it is for blank to, sorry, it is for blank to blank holder. Now another one, this time it is a blank to punch. Now if you see, the contact side is always a flexible body and the target side is always a rigid body. Or as we are only interested, or we can also give contact in such a way like we want the results only in the blank. So our mesh will be finer in the blank material rather than all those components. These are the rigid bodies, we are not concerned about those. So that's the reason the mesh will be finer in the blank compared to other components. So the finer mesh will be a contact, finer mesh will be a contact, and the other than a contact will be a target. So now here you see it's all our bonded contact by default. Under the type, you can see it's a type bonded, no separation, frictionless, rough and frictional. So the bonded and the separation are the linear contacts, and whereas frictionless, rough and frictional are the non-linear contacts. So I'm changing, so I'm multi-selecting all the contacts, press Ctrl and select all the contacts you want for multi-selection and change it to frictional. So now for blank to punch, the coefficient friction value is 0.14. Now for these two, it is 0.004. Now here we have to change from formulation, from program control to augmented Lagrange. Now update normal stiffness factor from 1 to 0.1 because our blank has to bend. That's the reason we are changing the normal stiffness factor to 0.1, so that lesser the material stiffness, the more will be the bending phenomena or the geometrical changes. So now here we have pinball region, change it to radius and set 0.5 mm, and here adjust to touch. Okay, this contact is removed, so let's just change it also from augmented Lagrange normal stiffness to a factor is 0.1, pinball radius 0.5, sorry, is 0 by default. This is 0.5 mm, and the interference treatment is add to adjust. So now if you carefully look at our geometry, from component to component, there is some gap, some clearance. Here you can see from one component to another component there is a gap. In my case, that is 0.2 mm of gap. It is created so that our component, different components will be acts separate components. If you don't give those clearance, the in the designing process, all the component, if you remove this clearance value, the all the components will act like one component. So whenever you select any component, whole component will get selected as if it act like a single component. So that's the reason to separate the component from each other, we have given 0.2 mm of clearance. So now, so which means for blank to, for example, which means for blank to punch, there is a 0.2 mm of gap. So the contact has to establish between punch and blank. So, but there is a 0.2 mm of gap. So if, so this 0.2 mm of gap should not be a, should not prevent from getting contact established. So that's the reason we are giving 0.5 mm. So what it does is it will create a 0.5 mm radius of sphere between, in our case here, blank to punch. That is this sphere, this 0.5 mm of sphere. So in this sphere, that 0.2 mm clearance is also covered, and some part of punch is covered and some part of blank is covered. So that this sphere will make sure that contact is established. So how it works is, the whatever the components comes under this sphere, that those components will form a contact. Now what is this interference treatment is, as we have 0.2 mm of gap, which should not be there in the physical world. So to remove it automatically, solver will remove this gap. It will cover that gap if you select the interference treatment to adjust to touch. So what, so here the load transfer will take place from punch to blank directly without considering this 0.2 mm of clearance. So now that is about contact.